During the WBC's 58th annual convention in the cyberspace. We are not in St. Petersburg, Russia, but you are watching everything from home, from the office, from the car, and we are joined by the whole world together. It is my great honor and pleasure to have one of the greatest champions in the history of the sport together with Oscar de la Hoya. My dear Oscar, ¿cómo estás? How are you doing, Oscar?
Muy bien, gracias. Thank you. Thank you very much. Just want to say hi to the whole WBC family all over the world. You know, obviously we're living some difficult times, some frustrating times, but I'm glad that we can all unite and discuss various subjects and what's going on in the boxing world. And you know, again, thank you for uniting us once again, Mauricio.
Thank you, Oscar. You have been with the WBC in our conventions all over the world, Argentina, Japan, Miami, Cancun, everywhere. And this time, the WBC decided to proceed with this type of convention virtually in order to understand that COVID-19 is a reality, but we have to move on. We have to remain active. And you have been very important to the WBC in these types of meetings. In Cancun, you were the key speaker. You gave us a beautiful message of encouragement. And I welcome you again. You are a very important member of the WBC family. And
Thank you.
You have fans from all over the world, members of the WBC watching. And what can you tell whoever is watching at this moment, what does a champion like yourself do when adversity comes?
Well, look, I mean, Mauricio, these are unprecedented times that we're living. These are times of frustration, of confusion, of patience. We must believe more than ever in the craft that we love, and that's boxing. And I'm very fortunate enough to have known the WBC family for forever. Ever since your father, may he rest in peace, gave me the opportunity, gave me the encouragement. He took me under his wing, you know, and that's something I'll never forget. But you know, we have to stay strong. I mean, this is a 12-round fight. This is a fight that is not an easy one. You know, we can win a few rounds, we can get knocked down, but we must remember that that we must get back up. And that's who we are as a family. That's who we are as a boxing community. We must stay strong. We must be very optimistic and remember that this dear sport is a sport that has impacted so many lives for so many years and will continue to endure adversity. But we must always think like a champion. We must always think like a world champion in that matter. So you know, let's continue being strong. Let's never give up, and this shall pass.
Absolutely. Thank you for those words coming from you, who has a long story and recorded history of being able to come back from adversity. You became a world champion. You have been a legendary champion, and you have always been a leader, a role model, and an inspiration to millions around the world.
Well, I really think, Mauricio, that's what our community is all about. Every single delegate, every single person, every single fighter, every single manager, promoter, you name it, that is in the boxing business, in the boxing world, we must remember that we're fighters, first and foremost. We're people who when we get knocked down, we get right back up. Because that's the sport that we love. That's the sport that we're in. And our mentality is one of a fighter. So, you know, I've, like you mentioned, I've been down and out several times. but I keep coming back up. I keep maintaining. The strength of enduring, and persevering, and moving forward. That's who we're all about. That's what our family is all about, and that's why I love boxing so much.
Oscar, I've been watching throughout this lockdown so many fights, and to watch those unbelievable moments in a boxing career, it is hard to understand the greatness of Oscar De La Hoya inside the ring. The speed, yeah. the power, and especially the guts. There was nothing that could happen in the ring that you would not go out and defeat. You defeated the greatest names in more than a decade in six different divisions. And you were very successful in the ring. Now you are very successful as a promoter. What is the difference between being a fighter and a promoter?
Obviously when you take a look at my career inside the ring, you know, it's really not that different of it outside the ring. You have to be strategic. You have to be smart. You have to know when to fight, when to pick your battles, when to ease off. There's many parallels with both careers that I've been living. But the one that stands out the most is always respect your opponent, always respect your peers, always, be fair. And I think that's the most important, advice that I received from people like your father, Mauricio, people like, Bob Arum, who was my promoter when I first started my career. I've been able to be successful in the ring because I was a hard worker. If I had to run 6 miles, I would run eight. If I had to spar 10 rounds, I would spar 14. It's same in business. Look, I've been very successful in business, because I'm very dedicated. I'm a person who never gives up, and boxing taught me those lessons. Boxing made me realize that it's all about perseverance. It's all about grinding every single day and making it work no matter what. So I'm grateful to this sport. I mean, I have a famous quote that I say all the time. It's like, I owe everything to boxing, and that's the honest truth.
That's beautiful. I spoke to Bernard Hopkins a few days ago, and he's telling me, first, you got to survive. You have to do whatever it takes to survive, and then you win. But these are challenging times, and there's a lot of depression, anxiety, uncertainty, but we're moving on. Things are improving. We will get by. And I love the way you say that we have to be like boxers and get up, train, concentrate, be patient, then you'll find the moment to win the fight.
Exactly.
So what have you been doing? You've been, during this lockdown, what has been your way of distraction?
Well, my way of distraction, obviously my kids, it's been wonderful, been seeing my older kids quite often, and my younger ones obviously, but let's just say that I've become a better golfer over these last few months. I've been having a lot of time playing golf, and basically just preparing for the future, preparing for what life has to offer after we get by these difficult times. I believe that there is tremendous, tremendous opportunity for the sport once we are through this pandemic. I strongly feel that the opportunities for boxing are bigger than ever once we get through this. And that's why it's so important that we unite, more than ever. And I'm talking about everyone. I'm talking about from the giants at network TV. I'm talking about to promoters and managers and fighters. We have to unite more than ever in order to continue growing this sport, because you know, I believe that the opportunities are endless. I can see it, I can feel it, and so, you know, we've been strategizing here at Golden Boy. We've been you know, having a lot of time to think about what the future holds, and I really feel that that once we're going to get by this, you know, the opportunities are going to be endless.
You had your first show under the COVID-19 era.
Yes.
How did it feel? What do you take as good? What do you take as bad? What are the areas of improvement to adjust to these times?
Well, I mean, first and foremost, obviously, we must secure the fact that everyone has to, you know, be safe and make sure that everyone is safe. And, you know, we were very proud of our team. You know, the fact that we tested about 190 people, including production and our Golden Boy staff. And we had, I believe, two people who tested positive, which is a not bad of a percentage, you know, in terms of people testing positive. So we were proud of that, but the commissions just did a wonderful job. The California State Athletic Commission did an amazing job in following protocol and making sure that everybody is safe. You know, we put on some great fights once again. Virgil Ortiz, as you know, is a tremendous, tremendous young fighter who is possibly the future of boxing. He demonstrated his abilities. We had amazing ratings on the zone. We were happy with everything, but most importantly, you know, everybody came out safe. Everybody was you know, following the rules and regulations, you know, even given these times. So we were proud of what we put together, and we're going to continue doing so. We're right now scheduled for another show in a couple of weeks. Unfortunately, Jorge Linares, who was our main event, tested positive in Japan.
Yes.
And you know, they did the correct thing in making sure that he is isolated and secluded, so he won't pass it on to anybody else. And so they, you know, their testing is amazing down in Japan. So, but unfortunately, our event will not showcase Jorge Linares. Our event will continue as planned on the same date. We at Golden Boy want to continue just giving the fight fans the best fights possible. So, you know, we want to thank obviously all the fans who tune in. But most importantly, I want to thank my, you know, matchmaker, Roberto Diaz, who is incredible. I want to thank my president, Eric Gomez, who does an amazing job. So, you know, it's a team effort. And that's exactly what boxing is. Boxing should be a team effort on a global scale.
You have a great staff, wonderful people, human beings, and Golden Boys, a very dear company, and individual, each one is a dear friend of us. And you are so right. We need to work together. If we have not been humbled by this pandemic, then we are already dead. This is the moment where we have to understand that there's no barriers. There's no way of putting things in the middle. We have to work together and make things happen. And you like sports. What are your favorite sports?
Well, I'm a huge football fan. You know, I mean, here in the U.S. we call it soccer, but you know, as you know, I'm a part owner of a Major League Soccer team in Houston, the Houston Dynamo, and I'm so glad that our regular, you know, schedule is back on track. We will continue our season in mid-August, and so, you know, we feel that, you know, I mean, especially for a Mexican American like myself, boxing and soccer have been, you know, the sports that I most follow, that I dearly love. So, you know, and another sport that I really love playing and participating in it is golf. Golf is a sport for me that that calms my mind. It calms the soul. You know, it's you against the golf course. It's you against the ball. So that one-on-one competition has been very, you know, important to me in my life.
Do you like Chivas or America in football?
Let's just say I love the Mexican national team.
That's a good one.
I'm not falling for that one, Mauricio.
And do you like baseball?
I love baseball. I grew up with Fernando Valenzuela, who's my dear friend. And, you know, baseball, the Los Angeles Dodgers, I mean, are my favorite team. And, you know, it's growing up with soccer, you know, boxing and baseball. I mean, those have been my favorite sports for forever.
You're a lefty, huh?
I'm a lefty. I actually, when I was 5 years old, my father first took me to the boxing gym, and I was my natural stance was lefty, and my very first trainer was confused, didn't know how to train me because I was lefty, so he just switched me over, and that's where the left hook and my left jab were born when I was 5 years old.
And that was a secret for many, many years, and that's how your jab became so strong, so important.
Yeah.
And like the left hook when you dropped Vargas, that was unbelievable. That was a tremendous hook.
Till the end of my career, I kept it a secret. I mean, people couldn't figure out my jab. Why is it so fast? Why is it so strong? That was my secret weapon for so many years.
And you never felt out.